Hello, I'm Grandmaster Mikhail Marin, and I invite you to examine together an ambitious, dynamic, and I would call it fascinating repertoire for White against several systems in the Slav opening. The Slav is very solid and flexible, and I would say to a certain extent irritating for White. I would start with the main core of our DVD, the position diagrammed here, the semi-Slav. Here there is a lot of theory. Black obviously has his ambitions. I mean, this is one of the most flexible setups. He's ready to take on c4 in any moment and then either consolidate his extra pawn with b5 or look for a counterplay. E3 is somehow not so easy to dominate. I have played it many times, but after knight bd7, black has all kind of move orders and it's not easy to control them all. Bishop g5 is ambitious, but then this is very heavily analyzed, both after h6 and d takes e4. Queen b3 I don't like so much because white loses too much time with his queen in a moment when he's not very well developed. And our main theme on this DVD will be the fianchetto. White tries to play in the spirit of the Catalan. Of course, this implies playing a lot of gambit lines, but this makes things more interesting. Bishop e7 is not very ambitious. For the Catalan opening, we have developed the knight on c3 a little bit early, but white can maintain the control in the center and he can count on a small advantage. Bishop d6 is a setup which is more effective if white has played queen c2 instead of knight c3, and then he would go knight bd2. Then the break with e5 would be knight bd7 and e5 would be relatively good for black, but with the knight on c3, white can still maintain the control. So the critical move is d takes c4. We should not hurry to take the pawn, we should play in gambit style, bishop g2. Now if b5, we can already play knight e5. And in view of the threats knight takes b5 and knight takes c6, white already has some initiative. Knight bd7 is more flexible, and then castling. And now, okay, there are moves such as bishop e7, keeping b5 in reserve since white doesn't threaten to take the pawn on c4 yet. Bishop b4, which looks ambitious but also exposes the bishop a bit. And the absolute main line b5, which can lead to very interesting positions. All these have a gambit character, and what is interesting in all these lines is that black plays his opening semi-Slav, and he takes the pawn usually. This is what he wanted to do, but we don't go into his play. We are also playing our opening. It's the Catalan, so it's already some sort of confrontation halfway between the two opponents. So we don't give black this moral satisfaction to play just his opening. No, we also play our own variation. Closely related to these systems is the triangle variation, where again we can go g3, and here of course play can transpose to the semi-Slav, but in principle black can deviate with knight e7, knight e7, all kind of developing move orders. But as we will see, this would not do anything good for him. And we also have the variation with a6, the Chebanenko Slav, which is also quite ambitious. Black simply wants to go b5, but okay, d takes c4 is also kind of a threat. And then again, we go g3. Now, if g6, then this would be a symmetrical Grünfeld where the move a6 is not of much use. The same applies to bishop f5 and bishop g4. Usually against g3, if white plays simply plays the Slav with g3, then both moves would ensure black comfortable play. But a6 is a waste of time and also slightly weakening, and white can hope for a small advantage. Dxc4, bishop g2 takes the game. It can actually transpose straight to the semi-Slav, the lines I mentioned above, but black can deviate a bit without getting any advantage out of this. So the position remains very similar to those from semi-Slav. Finally, if b5, then b3. And it's not very clear if black has achieved that much. We keep the tension. In all the cases, there are the same three main systems of development. And the fact that black has gained some queenside space is compensated by the fact that he also has weakness on that wing, and he has wasted a tempo. He played a6 and b5, and we reacted with only one move, b3. Finally, there is when you build up a repertoire. All these lines are quite interesting for white. Of course, it's a philosophical question whether they offer an advantage. But okay, this happens in all the openings. But I believe they offer good chances to retain an initiative. But somehow, having examined all these lines, I became curious to check whether we can meet the classical Slav Dxc4 with the same method. I have recorded the one video, the last one, and I have recommended it more as an experiment, but in principle it is playable. I would rate white's chances to retain the initiative as slightly lower as in all other systems, but I believe that it can be fun anyway. So now time has come to look at things more concretely.